I want to talk about there's something about the name of Jesus. And when you're going through something, I want you to say boldly to yourself, the name of Jesus. No matter the size of the problem, let your life speak Jesus. When I say there's something about the name Jesus, I'm talking about his power. I'm talking about his love and his compassion. Jesus walked this earth for 30 years before he performed his first miracle. Jesus had compassion on those who were sick because in his word, he said, I didn't come here for the whole people. He said, I came here for the sick and brokenhearted. And my friends, Jesus is the answer to everything. And that means your whole being must be centered in Christ. And in Philippians 2, 5 through 11, it says, let this mind be in you, which is also in Christ Jesus, who, being in the form of God, did not consider it robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation, taking the form of a bondservant and coming to the likeness of men, and being found in the appearance of a man, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even the death of the very name of the, no, even the death of the cross. Therefore, God also has highly exalted him and given him the name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow, of those in heaven, of those on earth, and those under the earth, and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is the Lord, to the glory of God the Father. So when you speak the name of Jesus, you are causing situations in your life to shift. Sickness must bow when you speak the name of Jesus. Demons must flee and acknowledge that Jesus is the Son of God. And shame and generational curses must be broken. And for my people who are dealing with sickness right now, I'm talking about real sickness. Jesus is a healer. It says in Luke 4, 38, Jesus left the synagogue and went to the home of Simon Peter. Now, Simon's mother-in-law was suffering from a high fever, and they asked Jesus to help her. So he bent over her and rebuked the fever, and it left her. She got up once again, and she began to minister to them. And at sunset, the people brought to Jesus all who have had various kinds of sickness, and laying his hands on each of them, he healed them. And moreover, demons came out of many people shouting, you are the Son of God. But he rebuked them and would not allow them to speak because they knew he was the Messiah. And when you speak the name of Jesus, listen, y'all, you're speaking the Prince of Peace. You're speaking Emmanuel, God with us. You're speaking Yeshua. You're speaking King of Kings, Lamb of God, the Way, the Good Shepherd, the Redeemer, Son of Man, Light of the World, Victory, the Great Physician. And I could go on, but I need you to understand that when you're dealing with your greatest battle, just know that you are not alone. Jesus said he's going to walk with you through this thing. And to the Darden, to Tracy Darden, to Charmaine Fairbanks, and Valencia Little, and the entire family, sickness cannot hold you. And right now, you need to be speaking the name of Jesus over your family, and you need to put a demand of healing and declare with your mouth that Jesus is going to heal your body. And it says in James 5, 14 through 16, it says, is anyone among you sick? Let him call for the elders of the church and let them pray over him and anoint them with oil in the name of the Lord. And the prayer of faith will save the sick, and the Lord will raise him up. And if he has committed sin, he will be forgiven. Confess your trespasses to one another and pray to one another that you may be healed. The effective, fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. So Heavenly Father God, I thank you. I thank you. I thank you. I thank you for this opportunity that you have given us to be able to pray. God, I thank you, Lord God, that you are King of Kings and Lord of Lords. And God, I come to you asking you very humbly that God, you will forgive us of our sins. You will forgive us of our ways, God. And Lord God, I pray right now that this prayer will go straight to heaven, God. And Lord God, I pray that heaven will back up this prayer, God, because I am asking for divine healing for Charmaine Fairbanks, God, in the name of Jesus. I'm asking for divine healing for Valencia Little right now in the name of Jesus, God. And I'm asking for anyone that's associated with this family that is dealing with the spirit of sickness, God, that Lord God, that you will send a spirit of healing in their household, God, and that God, that they will anoint themselves with oil, God, and they will pray over their bodies and they will declare that Jesus has healed their body. By his stripes, they are healed. By his stripes, they are healed. So God, we thank you for Isaiah 53:4-5, where you said, by his stripes, they are healed. So God, I thank you, Lord God, that your healing power is hitting their house, is hitting their land, that is hitting their atmosphere, God. And if there's anyone on this call who is dealing with sickness, if there's anyone whose family member who is dealing with a sickness, God, I pray that you will come against that spirit right now in the name of Jesus, God. I pray, God, that you will cancel out the spirit of coronavirus, that you will cancel out the plague, God. And Lord God, that plague will go back to the pits of hell. God, I ask right now, God, that you cleanse the atmosphere. God, that you cleanse the bloodline right now, God. God, I ask right now that everything that's going on in the body, God, if it's a fever, God, if it's the heart, God, if it's the lungs, God, I pray right now, God, that you will make it cease, that you will bring it back into order, God. God, I'm asking for divine healing based off of your will, based off of your strength and your power, God. Because Lord God, we are nothing without you. We're nothing. So God, I ask God that you continue to lift us up, that you continue to push us forward, God, because Lord God, they have a purpose. They have a plan, God, for their life. And Lord God, I know for a fact that you have not failed them yet. So God, if there is any spirit of doubt, God, I come against the spirit of doubt right now. I come against the spirit of depression. I come against the spirit that is trying to say that this is not going to work out. Heavenly Father, God, I thank you so much, God, that Lord God, that you're giving reassurance that you have never failed them once. And God, I thank you, Lord God, that their bodies are healed. I thank you, Lord, that everyone on this call is healed, God. And I pray that Psalms 91 will hit their life, that Psalms 91 will hit everyone's life, God, where it says, God, in the Bible, where it says that no accident, no plague will come our way, God. So I thank you, God, for breaking, for canceling anything that is not like you. Heavenly Father, God, I ask that you would heal us in every area of our life, that God, that you will make us whole, but even with our lips, even with our mouth, God, that we would learn how to praise you, God, because somebody needs to get back into alignment with you. Somebody needs to know that prayer and worship and praise is essential to their life, God. And Lord God, if there's anyone in need of something, God, I pray that they will open their mouth, God. I pray that they will believe and trust in who you are. And God, I just thank you, Lord, for your strength. I thank you, God, for your power, God. And I thank you for all things, Lord God. I pray that, God, that generational curses will be broken tonight, God. I pray that, God, that you would cleanse the bloodline, God, that it would end tonight. I come against anything that's dealing with shame and depression. God, even the past history of sexual assault, God, I pray that it be broken right now in the name of Jesus, God. Lord God, I ask for the healing of the mind, where even in the healing of the mind, God, that pressure is upon the mind, God, I pray that you will release it right now in the name of Jesus, God. And there's anyone who's dealing with issues in their back, God, I pray that you will put it back into alignment, God, that you will go into the cells and the muscles, God, and God, that you will straighten things out. And if there's anyone who's dealing with pain, I'm talking about pain in their head, migraines, God, I ask that you will heal them right now in the name of Jesus, God. Lord God, touch us from the head down to our feet. God, I thank you, Lord, but I ask for permission that your people on this call tonight, God, that they will worship and they will praise, God. I ask for everybody to unmute yourself, God, so they will be able to praise you. So please unmute yourself so that we can worship.
Amen.
God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, God, for everything that you're doing, God. We thank you, God, for just the war cry that we have tonight. Lord God, we thank you, God, for the fire. The blood of Jesus. Everybody say Jesus. Say Jesus. Speak his name. When you speak his name, things must change right now, God. Something got to break with the name of Jesus. Come on, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, God. Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Jesus must be lifted. His name must be lifted. Everything about Jesus must be real tonight, y'all. God is real. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Fix everything that needs to be fixed, God. Forgive us of our sins, God. Lord, God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Because you said when we say your name, things must shift. I say your name, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God. Can't nobody do you like Jesus. Glory be to God. Charmaine, do not stress. Just because they told you something, God said, trust him. Just because they told you something, he said, trust him with your whole life. He said, set the atmosphere in your house. Put the oil on you. Anoint your child, Charmaine. Everybody on this call, we support you. We're praying for you. You are not by yourself. God got you. Charmaine, it's okay. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God. Thank you, Lord. Oh, God.